Hello and welcome to UiPath's Automation Cloud. Our cloud platform was designed to facilitate stepping into a cloud-first automation future for the enterprise segment by making it easy to deploy, operate, and scale a robotic factory without adding any weight to existing hardware or infrastructure. Automation Cloud brings UiPath products from each of our automation pillars together into one cohesive automation platform, where users with the greatest or most modest involvement with automation can all depend on a single solution. Let's start by introducing you to the main elements of the interface. In particular, we'll be going over the shared interface options that are available to all users of all services. The first thing that you see when you log into Automation Cloud is the homepage, where you can get an overview of your automation ecosystem. In the top right corner, clicking your initials lets you access user preferences and the sign out option. Next to the user menu, you have the tenant list. You can switch to the context of a different tenant from within any service, and the available services, as seen on the left rail, Automation Cloud's navigation bar, change according to the services that are available in the selected tenant. Let's look at the admin page. This is where your organization's administrators can manage tenants, accounts and groups, and other high-level settings for the organization that should apply across all tenants, all services, and for all users. Finally, the help icon opens the resource center. From here, your RPA developers can download UiPath Studio, or users can access useful resources for the UiPath ecosystem. Now let's consider an enterprise company looking to deliver faster, but without the expense of upgrading its own infrastructure. This company has branch offices in the US and in EMEA, and each branch has its own HR and finance departments. In terms of employees, each of these departments have automation developers, those who design automation projects in Studio, and automation users, those who use the automations on their machines. And then there are organization administrators, who are in charge of configuring and managing Automation Cloud for everybody, across branches and departments. Let's see how an admin would go about getting started with Automation Cloud. First, an organization administrator needs to configure the environment. We start by creating a tenant for each business region in the company. All tenants come with an orchestrator service, and we can add other services as needed for each region. Next, we create a folder for each department in the tenant to group the automation specific to that department's tasks. So, for the EMEA tenant, we need the two folders for each department, HR and Finance. Then, we need to ensure that everyone has access to the automations that they need. Since we have employees with different automation roles in each department, we need different access levels for each. In Automation Cloud, we use groups to set the roles, licenses, and even robot configuration that a particular user type needs so that we can manage users in bulk and onboard users quickly. We provide ready-to-use groups for the main automation personas, but you can also customize your own. For the purposes of this example, the default groups, automation developers and automation users, are exactly what we need, each corresponding to that specific user persona. Let's go with those. With organization configuration complete, it's time to add users to the Automation Cloud organization. We need to navigate to Admin, select the Accounts and Groups page, and click Invite Users. Type in the user email addresses, choose the groups that have the appropriate setup for these users, and click Invite to confirm. With everything set up, it's down to the employees to make use of the platform. After an automation developer accepts the invite, they'll become able to log in to Automation Cloud. Then they can download UiPath Studio from the Resource Center. After connecting their robot to Orchestrator, they can then begin their automation journey right away. A package that's been published to Orchestrator becomes a consumable for an automation user once it's been deployed as a process in the folders to which the automation user has access. To To do this, in the context of the desired folder, navigate to Automations and add a new process from the corresponding package. Fill in the other fields and you're good to go. Packages published to a personal workspace are automatically deployed as processes in the context of that workspace. For enterprise automation users, UiPath Assistant is generally installed on their machines by their IT department. They just need to bring Assistant up, and their processes are available for them to run on demand. Now your entire organization is ready to start down the automation path. Happy automation!